Hello and welcome to our today's how-to video about the PV surplus charging with the Fronius Wattpilot. In this video, we are going to show you which settings you need to take to optimize your PV surplus charging with the Fronius Wattpilot. Please note, this video is being captured with the software version 1.5.0. And of course, whenever you're doing settings on your Wattpilot device, you can easily reset them with the RFID reset card. So whenever you're taking settings that you want to reset, you can just reset the Wattpilot to factory settings and therefore reset all the settings that you have done. Okay, so now for the commissioning and of course for the settings in the PV surplus energy, we need to access our Fronius Solar Wattpilot app. In the Wattpilot app, you can now see the point settings. And when we click here down below on the point settings, then you can find the point cost optimization. This is the third option that you have here in the list. When you now click on cost optimization, it will open up the PV surplus optimized settings. Yeah, when you scroll down this window, you can see now here the point use PV surplus energy. And you can activate and deactivate this functionality by just dropping in and on the button. Yeah, second on, you can choose your inverter. And please note, whenever you do the first commissioning of the Wattpilot will automatically search for an existing inverter in your connected network. So whenever you have an inverter already connected, you see the red check sign on the right side, and you can always add another inverter if you want to draw the data from a different inverter in that system. However, please make sure to always choose the inverter that is connected with the Fronius smart meter at the feeding point of the household, or the inverter that you use for the energy management functionality of the whole system. This is of course important that the Wattpilot always gets the correct data from the inverter to regulate your PV surplus charging correct. Yeah, when we have that, we can see now down below two further settings. It is PV battery threshold and ohm pillar threshold, and we will go through these prioritization thresholds in another video. What we are going to look now is the PV surplus settings, and you can now click on advanced settings. And here in the PV surplus settings, you can see the detailed values that you can configure for optimizing your experience with the Fronius Wattpilot. First of all, we are going to start with the starting power level. And as you see, this is now configured standard to 1.4 kilowatts. This is due to the fact that every electric vehicle needs a minimum charging current to start the charging process. So for most of the vehicles out there, this is 6 amps. And when you're charging on a single phase with 6 amps, this is 1.38 kilowatts. So therefore, the factory setting is at 1.4 kilowatt. And that means that whenever your inverter is producing 1.4 kilowatts of PV surplus energy, then the Wattpilot will start the charging with 6 amps at the electric vehicle. Of course, you can alternate this value as you wish. So for example, if you have a very small PV system and you want to make sure that the electric vehicle can charge earlier, you can lower this grade. So for example, you can set here 0.5 kilowatts. This would ensure that the electric vehicle will start the charging process earlier, and whenever you don't have the full potential, the full 1.4 kilowatts available, the electric vehicle will charge whenever there is, in this case, 500 watts available of PV surplus energy. This can be useful when you're using a very small PV system so that your car gets to charge more often. On the other hand side, if you have a bigger system, you can decide to set this value up. And especially if you have an electric vehicle that has a very bad charging efficiency at low currents. So for example, your car needs 8 or 9 or 10 amps to charge efficiently. Then you can raise this value to make sure that you have an efficient charging process. Please note, however, if you alternate this value, and especially if you lower it to, for example, 500 watts, it can be that the Wattpilot will then take energy from the public grid, or in other case, when you have a PV stationary battery storage, it will also take the energy coming from this PV battery if it is still charged. So if you want to avoid this, you can just set the value as it was, so to 1.4 kilowatt. And then make sure that you don't have energy being drawn from the battery storage or energy from the public grid. So whenever you want to avoid this, you can then use the eco mode to charge with PV surplus energy only to avoid energy coming from the grid or from the battery storage. Yeah, then the second option is here the zero feed-in, and you can optimize the Wattpilot to a zero feed-in regulation to make sure that no energy from your PV system is being fed into the public grid and that you use all your energy at your own. Please make sure, however, when you're setting the zero feed-in limitation here in the Wattpilot, you also need to set it in your Fronius inverter. This is very vital so that the regulation of the zero feed-in can be done correctly by the inverter and by the Wattpilot. Therefore, both systems need to know that that this is a zero feed-in system. So, and the third point is then the control behavior. And this control behavior should give you the full control of your PV surplus charging. And therefore, you see you have three opportunities. You have prefer power from grid, prefer power to grid, and the default mode. Whenever you're charging your electric vehicle, as I said before, you have stepped charging regards to the currency. So in this case, the charging process starts at 6 amps and then the Wattpilot will regulate to 7 amps, 8 amps, 9 amps, 10 amps, and so on. So that means that we have little steps that we need to control. In this case, for a single phase charge, this is 230 watts steps that the Wattpilot will regulate to the car. And now we give you the possibility to regulate this charging process at a very precise level. So whenever you want to make sure, for example, that the Wattpilot is not drawing any energy from the public grid, not even some watts, then you can set the settings to prefer power to grid. This would mean that the Wattpilot will wait to the next current step until the needed power is really available from the inverter. So it will wait until the full 230 watts are available until the Wattpilot will jump to the next level. On the other hand side, you can switch to the setting prefer power from grid and therefore make sure that the Wattpilot will jump to the next stage earlier. And this would mean that whenever you have, for example, the full 230 watts available, and then the inverter is delivering an extra of 20 watts, then the Wattpilot will instantly jump to the next current level, so to, for example, to 7 amps, and of course will draw energy from the public grid. But however, if you have an electric vehicle and you want to make sure that it is charged more often, then you can use this control behavior to make sure that your electric vehicle is charged at a faster pace and that the control is more behaving like a high power charging. Yeah, and then the last but not least, of course, the default mode. This is also set by default. This would mean that the power that is needed is divided into 50-50. So this would mean that at the single phase charging at 230 watts, that at 115 watts, the Wattpilot will jump to the next charging level. So this would mean that you have a balanced charging control and that your Wattpilot will make sure that he uses the most out of the PV system to have a good control behavior. So as you can see, this gives you the opportunity to regulate your PV surplus charging at the very precise level and to make sure that you can use the Wattpilot as you want to. At last, when you have finished the settings in here, you can hit the save button. Save the options and save the settings, and therefore make sure that you can now charge your electric vehicles on your terms and charge like you want. So I hope this video was informative for you. I hope you can now set the settings on your Wattpilot correctly, and see you the next time. Stay healthy and keep charging. Bye bye.